Good morning, children. Take our English all in one children. Term one. All in one. English test lesson one completed now. This grammar points the kinds of sentences and writing the kinds of sentences in the given blanks and all. Next, putting the punctuation marks. Okay, lesson one. Test one grammar. And here see. Page number 14 and 15. Today's class is about page number 14 and 15 of lesson 1 textual grammar. So, see, learn to communicate. What is called communicate and what is called communication? Listening and speaking. Conversation. How? What is called conversation when two persons are talking now? Two boys or two girls or your friends. Isn't it your parents? You are talking with your parents are talking with your friends. That is called conversation, isn't it? See, learn to communicate. How to communicate? See here, listening and speaking. What is heading children? H. See, your teacher will read out the following passage about disasters. Already you know about disasters. Disasters. Listen to your teacher carefully and answer the questions orally. See, this is one paragraph they have given about disasters. Actually, what is the name of the lesson, children? Here, see. What is the name of the lesson? A precious drop in the ocean. Teacher already explained you know about this lesson and disasters and cyclones and everything. See that only. So this para is belonging about this para is consist about the main matter about disasters. What is the meaning of disasters? Already teacher explained, you know. See, natural calamities. There are some natural calamities and there are some man-made disasters also are there. See, what are those? See, suppose example disasters is what you know. See, cyclones. Isn't it? And floods, children. And next, earthquakes. Disasters. See, that told about this paragraph. Disasters are either man-made or natural. Natural calamities, cyclones, floods, earthquakes, natural calamities. These are not done by man-children. These are not man-made disasters. These are all natural disasters. Isn't it? Natural disasters. Natural disasters are that which occur on their own. Whose own? Not my own and your own. Isn't it? Nature's own. On their own without any human intervention. Human intervention. Because see, there is no human participation. There is no human participation. Or human beings are not taking part in these natural calamities. Isn't it? See, man-made, there are some man-made disasters. Just now I told you, man-made disasters are there, natural disasters are there. But cyclones, floods, earthquakes are natural disasters. In these disasters, there is no human beings intervention. There is no participation of humans, isn't it? See, man-made disasters, on the other hand, are those that happen due to human actions. What is the best example of man-made disaster, you know? Indiscriminate of cutting trees, children. Yes. Deforestation goes on cutting the trees. That's what nowadays we are unable to see some animals and birds. Isn't it? See, indiscriminate cutting of trees leads to pollution and soil erosion, and it also increases the threat of global warming. What is called global warming? See, everywhere, heat. Everywhere pollution, smoke pollution, noise pollution, water pollution, isn't it? So, soil pollution, erosion, and it also increases the threat of global warming. Some disasters can be both natural and man-made. What are those? Some will be there. So, some occur by only nature. Those are called natural disasters or natural calamities. And some are there man-made disasters. I told you, no? What? Cutting trees, especially this done by humans only, okay? Yes, next one more is there, natural water, nature and as well as what children, man-made. So see, some disasters can be both natural and man-made, like forest trees, children, yes. forest trees. Due to excessive heat, no, sometimes no, automatically the trees started burning themselves in the forest. Especially some hunters know, goes on what? Burn the trees children. So this comes under what you know? Natural disaster as well as man-made disaster, especially forest trees. Cutting trees, discriminative cutting trees is especially man-made disaster. Cyclones, floods and earthquakes are natural calamities, natural disasters. In this there is no human's intervention children. So but forest trees is natural disaster and man-made disaster. Forest trees, see, natural disasters cannot be controlled, but they can be predicted at times. But we can use some precautions in floods time or cyclones time. No, broadcasting this one or that, they are giving the information through loudspeakers, radio, TV channels. Just not to go to so far in the oceans and all, for especially for fishermen, isn't it? So up to some extent, no, we can give the precautions for these natural calamities. See, predicted at times, man-made disasters, however, can be prevented altogether if human beings are more careful with how they treat their environment. What is the environment? Our surrounding itself is called our environment. All the human beings together to control the what? Man-made disasters, especially cutting trees. This is depending upon humans children. This also, this we can, up to some extent we can control this, what, natural disasters or natural calamities. Okay, now here this is the brief history of natural disasters. This is the para, and here now see, cutting trees. It goes on cutting trees, then where is greenery? So here they have given some questions, 1 to 4 questions. You have to write the answers in your homework book children. Go through these 4 questions and write the answer. And next, see, writing is there now. You have read about how a group of motivated children helped the disasters affected people in Chennai. Already teacher explained you about this lesson, no, about Chennai disaster. So how would you help? Suppose if you are in the place, how would you help a community of people suffering from disaster, either individually or in group? How will you help the people, affected people, victims, flood affected people, okay, cyclone affected people? What is your part? What is your responsibility? How will you collect the money or what are the funds? Not only money, fund in the form of clothing, isn't it? Food grains, isn't it? Money, door-to-door canvas, or making a group with your friends. How will you take part to help the victims? Isn't it? Flood victims or cyclones, if you see. Individual or in group, write it down in your notebook. You write these two, this one, no, answers in your English homework book, children. Okay? Right.